Hello, and welcome back to my channel, Mend with Mare. All right, I have heard your requests, and I'm going to be reacting to Forever Winter by Taylor Swift. And I do feel like a little bit of a fraud Taylor Swift fan because I haven't listened to this yet. I know that she re-released the Red album, Taylor's version, and I had listened to a few of the songs that were from The Vault, but I hadn't gotten to Forever Winter. I'm gonna be reacting for you all. So I'm not gonna waste any time. I'm just gonna jump right into it. I don't know what it's about, so let's do it.
He says he doesn't believe anything that she hears these days. He says, why fall in love just so you can watch it go away? He spends most of his nights wishing it was how it used to be. He spends most of his flights getting pulled down by gravity.
Okay, so it sounds like she's speaking about somebody that she knows or loves that is down and out, wondering like, what's the point? It doesn't sound like just with life. It sounds like just with love. It's somebody who has been really, really hurt by a relationship. That's what I think right now. And saying like, why fall in love so you can watch it go away? And spending nights like wishing it could be how it used to be. And how he's spending most of his flights getting pulled down by gravity. Gravity is a very, very strong force. So flights getting pulled down by gravity, that's not a good thing. That sounds harsh to me, at least. And I'm not a great flyer.
I hate flying.
She's just hearing about him feeling sad and not sure if love is any good.
I call just checking up.
So she's saying that she's checking up on this person. He's saying this isn't a phase. When somebody is hurting and losing a love that they cherish, sometimes you have to know that it's just a phase in order to get through it, or other people telling you that. But it sounds like this person, he's telling her, this isn't just a phase. I'm really messed up by this. And this feels deeper than what I expected. I know what this feels like when you wish somebody understood how much you care about them, and you wish that they understood how much you would... I don't know why I'm getting emotional. How much you would fall apart if they weren't around, and that it would feel like forever winter if they weren't there. I'll be summer sun for you forever. That is, I relate to that. That optimistic part of yourself that you're like, I will shine bright for you if you stay around. I'll be your sun. I will be there for you. But if you go, it'll be like forever winter. Unfortunately, it sounds like he feels like he's in his forever winter. The line, too young to know it gets better, is a hard one because a lot of young people tend to not have that understanding that love hurts very badly, but that you can heal and you will move on, and that it will get better at some point. It may not be right away, but eventually it will get better.
He seems fine most of the time, forcing smiles and never minds. His life is a symphony. When the lights go out, it's hard to breathe. I pull at every thread, trying to solve the puzzles in his head. Live my life scared to death. He'll decide to leave instead.
Feeling concerned. Let me go back for a second really quick. I need to hear that again. So trying to solve the puzzles in his head, like you're trying to help him understand and piece it all together so that he can understand his life and to help him. And I really like where she says that his laugh is a symphony. I love the word symphony. I love the song Bittersweet Symphony. It's up there in my top five. Where she talks about his laugh as a symphony, but when the lights go out, it's hard to breathe. And that can be how difficult it is to put on a mask for everybody that you're okay when really you are suffering tremendously. So it sounds like he's faking it and hiding it from the people that love him so much. So 5 a.m. wasted, long gone, not even listening. My voice comes out screaming. Somebody is so afraid that I think that he might harm himself. Maybe my mind always goes there, but that's because I talk about suicide on a daily basis. And I assess for it quite often with my clients because based on the research, the more that you talk about any type of suicidal thoughts that you're having, the less likely that you will end your life. That's one study. There is conflicting research against that. But that's why I feel you should always talk about any of those thoughts, whether they're passive, like I just don't want to wake up. I wonder if anybody would care if I was here or not, to actual thoughts and plans to end your life. We have to talk about them because it's stored in your system and you're alone with it. And just even sharing it with someone else will help you to cope with it and let somebody else know how bad it really is. And that's it's so important. I don't think that that's, maybe I'm just being too extreme here. So she's concerned about him though. That I know, that I can tell. Is this really, oh God. If I was standing there in your apartment, I'd take that bomb in your head and disarm it. This makes me worried that she's being, realistic here. A bomb in your head, like, someone shooting themselves in the head and disarm it. It could be bombs, like maybe the bomb that could be in your head telling you to take your life that and you shouldn't. Oh, I think this is. Oh God. I don't know if I can do this right now. Oh God. I don't know. I didn't know. Okay. I need a moment. Wow. This could also... Oh, I didn't want to cry. I can't help but cry. You know what? Crying is okay. I just got really insecure about crying on video and that this is going to be on the internet probably forever. But vulnerability is important because I believe it's contagious and we need to be vulnerable. And oftentimes when I have clients that cry in front of me and they're apologetic, I'm like, let the tears flow because we have these tear ducts for a reason. It's important to cry and to let out the emotion. And it's important because people are important. And I hear that desperation in her. She's very worried about whoever he is. And she doesn't want him to do something that he would regret or that he would not be there. It would be tragic. And hearing the Wasted lyrics, you know, insinuating that that he's drinking and that he is really leading into addiction, and that is showing that he's really struggling and that she's trying to be his forever son. It is really hard when there's young people that are suffering because they really don't totally understand that it can get better. And so hearing that it's a young person, it really gets to me. And I know what it's like to lose someone by these means. And so it just makes it more emotional for me. And I can only imagine how you all might feel. And because you all recommended this song. And so I know I'm not the only one who would react this way to a video. So thank you for the recommendation. And there was someone that commented on the Renegade video and said, you know, it's weird that Taylor gets a reputation for just writing breakup songs because she writes so much more than that. And this is a big part of that. And this was clear back in the Red era. So she can really capture the sentiment. So thank you all for watching this. Again, I'm probably going to go for a good cry. I hope you all enjoyed this. Me crying. And please like and subscribe to the video, and I will have more content for you soon. Please let me know what you want me to talk about. It doesn't have to just be reaction videos. I'm happy to talk about anything. Okay. All right. Oh, I need a tissue. Take care.